Good morning, our dear student. Today we will revise together the histological structure of RBCs and platelets. Blood is a viscous fluid. It's considered as a special type of connective tissue. Being mesenchymal in origin, blood is composed of cells suspended in plasma. Preparation of blood film. A drop of blood is placed on a clean microscopic slide. Another slide is used to disperse the blood over the slide's lens. The blood film is left to dry for 5 minutes. The dried blood film is then stained with Leishman's stain to be examined by light microscope. Here is a diagram showing the way for preparation of a blood film. Erythrocyte RBCs by light microscope appear as deep pink color due to their hemoglobin content and showing rounded biconcave disc. Here is a blood film showing RBCs pointed by arrow that display rounded biconcave disc and a neutrophil with lobulated nucleus marked by arrowhead is also present in this blood film. Here is another blood film showing RBCs that show a central clear region representing the sinister area of the biconcave disc. This is marked by arrow. Erythrocyte by electron microscope using scanning electron microscope. This scanning electron microscope showing the rounded biconcave shape of RBCs, rouleau appearance marked by arrow is also seen. By transmission electron microscope, no nuclei or organelles. The cytoplasm has a uniform granular density due to the presence of hemoglobin. Here is a transmission electron microscope of the erythrocyte. In the lumen of a capillary, the erythrocyte like organelle, their uniform granular density is due to the presence of hemoglobin and endothelium surrounding the capillary. Reticulocytes are immature erythrocytes. 1% of the total number of circulating erythrocytes. It is 8 micron in diameter, larger than mature erythrocyte. It has no nuclei. It has free ribosomes and few mitochondria. By light microscope, they can be stained by a supravital stain called brilliant crystal blue. Here is a light microscopic picture stained by brilliant crystal blue, showing reticulocyte appear as a blue stained network reticulum or few blue dots marked by arrows. Electron microscopic picture of reticulocyte, the nucleus is not present and the cytoplasm shows the characteristic process that occurs just after nuclear extrusion. Mitochondria and ribosomes are still present. Blood platelets, thrombocyte by light microscope, they are non-nucleated cytoplasmic fragments. Here is a blood film showing thrombocyte marked by arrows that are non-nucleated cytoplasmic fragment. By transmission electron microscope, platelets are surrounded by cell membrane covered by a thick cell coat, glycocalyx, the hyalomere and the granulomere. The hyalomere consists of 4 items, an open canalicular system, a dense tubular system, a bundle of microtubule, actin and myosin filament. While the granulomere contain mitochondria and peroxisome, glycogen granule, numerous vesicles, membrane-bounded dense granule. Here is a transmission electron microscope of platelet showing a peripheral hyalomere with open canalicular system and a system of microtubule and actin filament. The central granulomere region contain a small dense delta granule, larger and more numerous alpha granule and glycogen. There is a scanning electron microscope of platelet. In case of minor trauma to vessels, the platelet aggregate, swell and release factor that trigger formation of fibrin network that trap erythrocyte forming a blood clot to prevent the bleeding. Here's a scanning microscope of blood clot showing the platelets, the fibrin, and the erythrocytes. Transmission electron microscope of megakaryocyte. It's a giant cell, huge lobulated nucleus with dense chromatin. The cytoplasm contains azurophilic granule, numerous mitochondria, well-developed RER and Golgi apparatus. Numerous invagination of plasma membrane extending throughout the cytoplasm, forming demarcation channels for the release of platelets. Here is a transmission electron microscope of a megakaryocyte, shows the lobulated nucleus, numerous cytoplasmic granules, and an extensive system of demarcation membranes through the cytoplasm. Let's now talk about bone marrow. Bone marrow is a specialized vascular connective tissue rich in cells that are responsible for formation of blood cells. Type is bone marrow, red bone marrow, and yellow bone marrow. Here is a light microscopic picture of a red bone marrow. Hematopoietic cells, including developing granulocyte, erythrocyte, and megakaryocyte, occupy spaces between bony trabeculae. There is also blood sinusoid observed between cells. While yellow bone marrow, it is inactive bone marrow. It's yellow in color due to great number of adipose fat cells. Here is a light microscopic picture of yellow bone marrow showing adipocyte occupies the bone marrow space and there is decrease in the ratio of hematopoietic cells. Thank you.